Hello, my friends. I just wanted to do a couple of quick videos to show you guys how to do some things, some basics for Lychee. So the first thing is when you load the program, this is what you'll see. Add files, which is pretty self-explanatory. Open your whatever file you want. I'm just gonna grab. Let's grab one of the Archvillain Games stuff. Where is that? Here we go. Giant grinning god. I'm gonna use this to show you guys some interesting features of Lychee that you might want to know about. Sometimes on the loading of models, it can take a little while. Just give it a sign. Now, this is obviously a giant model. So the first thing you notice is it's too big for the plate, which is, in this case, okay. Now, you can move models about just like usual, and it starts in default in move mode. Now, there are keyboard shortcuts, and then there are also the shortcuts right over here. But to do rotations, it's R rotates. And then to do translations, it's T for translate. You might think move, but that does something different. So to switch back and forth, again, it's basically the things you switch back and forth between are M for move, or M, sorry, T for translate, and R for rotate. T for translate. R for rotate. Now right down over here in the bottom left hand corner, it shows you which printer you have selected, what resin, and your other information. It doesn't matter which one you click on, any of you're fine, and it brings you to this screen. As you can see, I have several printers that are here. If you don't already have your printer, it's pretty easy. You can click add, or you can click add. We'll go ahead and walk you through that. So you hit add, you choose which printer you want. So in this case, let's say that you're picking up an Elegoo and you're getting one of the new Mars Saturns. So you click on the Mars Saturn. Now you notice it put it right here at the top. So the next thing you can see, if you got, it says default, default, and default. These are the default settings. I recommend you just go ahead and come over here and you click the gear and you change these. The first thing you're going to do is click on advanced options so everything is up. So this top part up here, burn-in layers, is your bottom layers. Burn-in layers are bottom layers. So whatever you're used to having your bottom layers as, which you'll set that to. Your cure time is the same thing. Now, again, in this context, the way they set it up here is all of the variables for burn-in layers are right here. All of the variables for normal layers are right here. So cure time, I like mine 65. Actually, this is a monochrome screen, so a little bit lower. Light off delay and lifting speed. So the first thing we're going to do is drop our lifting speeds down to reasonable, because the defaults on all of these machines are always insane. And lift after print on these guys actually needs to be a little higher than 5, so I'm going to go 7. And then light off delay is now going to be 7 seconds. And the way that you know that is that because I'm doing 60 millimeters per second, that's 1 millimeter per second, lift after print, 7 inches or 7 millimeters up, so it's going to take actually 14 seconds. We'll give you true time because it's 7 seconds up and 7 seconds down. Now we come to our normal layers. Layer thickness. This is measuring in microns. UM is microns. If you're not used to that, you can just click on it and set millimeters, centimeters, or inches. I recommend microns. 50 microns is the same thing as 0.5, if what you're, or 0.5. If you're used to printing at 0.05 layer height, that is 50 microns. Now your light off delay is going to be the same thing here, so we'll start with our cure time, which on a Saturn is not going to be 8 seconds. It's probably going to be more like 3.5 seconds. And again, lift after print, we want to come up a little bit higher, so we'll go ahead and call that 7, which will make our light off delay about 14 seconds. Now, speed here refers to normal layers, so we're going to go ahead and set that again to something reasonable. I recommend 40 to 60. Your lowering speed is the same thing as retraction. Go ahead and leave that as where it is. 150 is fine. And then on your bottle price, whatever it happens to be. Mine is generally about 35 USD. You can also switch it to wherever primary currency you happen to use. And then liters, cubic liters, or milliliters, as the case may be. And then you hit OK. Now that's all saved. Now, if you wanted to have different resins, you can have add. Then it's the same thing as before, where you're just going to set your name and then your colors. any comments that you might want to have, and then it's going to be the same thing, your number of burn-in layers all the way down. And then once you do that, they'll be over here. Actually, I should show you that just so you can see. I'm not going to actually change this, but you'll see that we now have under Elegoo Saturn, under, because I didn't change anything, it's the default brand, the default resin. But if I come over here and I change this real quick, let's actually... yes. Let me go ahead and remove this, I think. Okay, so you can't actually delete them. But, like, let's say I just wanted to... Oh, wait, no, that's why I couldn't delete it. I was clicked on the wrong one. Because they won't let you delete the official one. Or they won't let you change the name. So let's go ahead and change this name real quick so that you'll see how it separates them out. So now you notice that we've got EPAX, hard gray, and then we've got default. And so it'll create brands and then names and then thicknesses. So you can have, it's a little bit more kludgy in the beginning to set things up, but then it's actually quite nice. So if you look over here, you know, my Anycubic Photon I'm basically only using for 0.5 and 0.1 because it's slow. My Mars Pro 2, I've got a 0.3, 0.5, and then my support profile at 0.2. My Sonic Mini, I've just got the 0.5s, and this guy is, I haven't really messed with it yet because I don't have the printer yet. So that's just a quick overview of how to add printers and such, and we'll go over some other stuff in a separate video.